how to install the virtual machine at your end. It's already been put into the blog, and from where you can, you know, check it out. Second, for the other installation, if you want to have the installation at your end, I will help you in getting all those things installed. Okay. So first some chapters, but let me impress you with what's going to happen in the coming classes. So first we will try to get some of our fundamentals. These fundamentals we will be carrying forward, and we will be building our exercises, our work on all these. So there may be cases where you may not understand those concepts, specifically people who are coming from the configuration field who have done already big guys, they may not be understanding concept of XML and all that. Nothing to worry about it. As you go ahead, you will all learn all these concepts, okay? And we are going to use only those parts of these concepts which is actually utilized in SOAP world, okay? So let me again repeat some of the points that all the exercises that I will be giving, you have to do it. And that will be, I think, ask as many questions as you can. And, if you have put into, you are into some technical issues, wherever you feel, hey, we are in some issues or, we have to do that, then obviously please contact us. Okay? I will take care of all of your technical issues. Okay. So what is the course objective? We retract all our course objectives. It would be good if everybody can be on mute for some time so that, it becomes easier. So after completion of this course, you should be able to explain what the service-oriented concepts are. So I will again say it's just a terminology, it's a framework, it's an open source framework that is there, an Oracle. So there are many vendor products for SOA. So we will see what SOA actually means and why this technology has evolved. So then we will go to the second point where we will say about what are the standards and specifications that make SOA. Can any system be said as a SOA oriented architecture, or are there some points that this type of system has to meet? So we will see all those. We will talk about the SOA reference architecture. We will then dig into the concepts where we will say what the Oracle provides to implement the service-oriented architecture is. Then we will talk about the service design considerations, like when you go for a project and what are the design considerations that you need to keep in mind. So then we will talk about composite application concept, which is newly added to the Oracle world. It was never there, so we will talk on those. And then we will understand working with different service components. So this is our roadmap. We will start building from the basics. We will move toward what the SCA is. We will talk about a little bit about administrations. We will talk about what the services actually mean in the real world. Then we will talk about what the component architectures are. We will talk about bands, how to monitor those services, mediators. We will talk about people, human tasks, business rules, and some of the security issues. So course curriculum, it's a SOA concept. We will be taking care of all. We will talk about all the web service concepts, visitors, XSD, XML, and XSLT, and we will see how you can build those using the the developers and all that, so that you can easily grasp these concepts. We will talk about what service component architecture means, what the people is, what a mediator is, what are human tasks, business rules, as well as what the Oracle service bus are, and BAM. I think these two are missing over here, but we will be talking on those. So I think don't go with the day one. So, this is some old slides. So here, for the first sessions, we will talk about, we will give you the introduction concepts of SOA. Then, we will talk about what SOA 11G as a product line is and what is new in the 11G. Then once we know what the SOA is, what is 11G, SOA 11G means, then we will dig into what a service is and we will talk about different artifacts that make a service. Then we will talk about the concept of SCA, which is a new thing that was introduced in the 11G version. Previously it was not there, and we will see why it has been introduced. Then we will see how to manage and monitor our applications. So this is from the perspective of a developer, and if you are interested, you can take it from the DBA level also. Then we will talk about a major thing about BAPL, what the BAPL means. We will thoroughly discover these people. We will go to its staff, what BAPL is all about. Then we will talk about what the mediators are, why the mediators are, and we will see where to use mediators and where to use BAPL. Then we will talk about human tasks, business rules, BAM, and I think OSP is missing, so we will be talking about all those. So after completion of this lesson, so today's lesson will be more about introduction. You should be able to describe what the challenges of integration enterprise application systems are. We will describe the solutions of enterprise application integration. We will talk about SOA maturity model. We will describe what SOA in a concept is. We will identify the standards, and we will design a basic requirement for the SOA approach. And in the last, we will describe a little bit about SOA governance. So let's start up. So what the SOA actually means is, SOA is an IT strategy that organizes discrete functions contained in enterprise applications into interoperable standard-based services that can be compiled and reused quickly to meet business needs. I know this is a big definition, but all what SOA does is, it is a strategy which tries to combine business strategy with IT strategy. And we will see how it does it, So what it means is, here the sum of the words are interoperable, standard-based. So we will talk about what interoperability and standard system means. So let's describe in a little bit what a standard-based service is. So SOA is a generic concept. It's not any vendor-specific concept. So what happened, many big companies like Oracle, IBM, and all these sat together and, they came up with a standard of web services-based architecture, and that was called SOA. After that, they started, it's an open source system. So it's an open system where, many non-profit organizations have actually put their effort to it, and they define those standards. So that's why So that's what is the SOA actually in a way means it. So first we should describe what in a real sense SOA services is. So what is SOA and why SOA? SOA enables usability, interoperability, scalability, and cost efficiency. These are very broad terms. Let's take an example for it. Previously in the world, what was happened was, as the organizations were going, so they were adding different systems for different stuff. Like for a HR system, they were using PeopleSoft, which is the best system. For their order management system, they started using Oracle. Order management, Oracle e-business suite. For manufacturing, they were having SAP system. So systems were getting added as and when the need of enterprise was. But then obviously they require a need to integrate it. So they started integrating each one with each other. Right. So now, the problem was, so this was a word of enterprise application integration, where integration with different system was being built. So now, if the new system has to be added, suppose we have to have a we have to add some new module, or maybe something like a keyboard system for CRM, I need to integrate with all of this. So if you see, as my number of systems are added, my integrations are not only become complex, but it's become harder to change. That means if I have to, remove tomorrow staff with some new system, I have to change everything. This is a huge cost to the company. So that's what the word is, cost efficiency. SOA brought cost efficiency, and we see how it is. So in the same scenario, let me change the pen. So in the same scenario, what SOA did was, SOA created its own system internally called a, so in the scenario, we started building the system something like this. Till the system was like this, the scenario started looking using SOA something like this. So if tomorrow I have to go away with the new system, this whole of my other system still remains effective. So this is what the concept of, the cost efficiency is. Now, if you see, maintaining this system is pretty cost effective than maintaining the earlier system. Then scalability and flexibility. Obviously, it's a scalable system because I can add as many systems as I want at any given point of time and remove it. So this was a change in approach. Then, so this is what the another benefit that we got from SOA. Then came the interoperability or loosely coupled service. Right? We will see what a service means, but at this moment I will just describe what a loosely coupled system means. Loosely coupled systems are the systems where the things can be added anytime, can change anytime, without affecting the whole system. So these type of systems are loosely coupled systems. I can change the new, remove the SAP and bring another system over here without affecting the whole of my business process. Then the reusability. Obviously, these were all services-based systems, and we will see what a service is, but let me give you an example of a service. You must have seen that when it comes to a weather service, most of the websites have something called a Yahoo. So what is the Yahoo web service does is, you send the zip code of a place and you get the weather of that particular place. Okay. So that's what the Yahoo web service is. So on many websites, you use the same system. That is a reusability. And the SOA being based on the services is highly reusable. So these are the four major points. That's why SOA is used and why organizations today are moving towards the SOA. So, enterprise challenge, lack of flexibility, no standard base, project cost, and long duration. We saw in the earlier scenarios why, we saw how complex the integration scenarios were becoming, and that's why they were adding the, the system. Traditional methodology, point-to-point, and enterprise application integration. I just give an example of what EI actually meant. So, this is an example of point-to-point integration. I have a CRM system, I have a client here, I have an ERP, so I'm using all these, how many integration layers I have, I'm pointing from each system to another system. So maintaining this system, a company has to maintain a lot of big teams. Secondly, company, when it's a change, it's a big enhancement project. So these systems, so the cost of that project goes absorbently high. So to remove this, SOA was introduced. This is what enterprise application integrations are mostly, where there was a middleware, all that, and we were pretty, which was pretty good as compared to what point-to-point is. But still, it was not that great. So that's why the concept of SOA came. Again, SOA is a middleware, but it's not a point-to-point. It has a lot of other stuff that is it. So what are the benefits? Reusable. It is based on services. All the services are usable.